and welcome to Celebrity Jeopardy. Before we begin the double Jeopardy round, I suggest to our viewers to watch something else. With that said, let's look at the scores. In first place, Sean Connery currently sits at 0.
You'll rue the day you cross me, Trebek.
I already do. And in second place, Burt Reynolds at negative 7,000.
That's not my name, Alex.
Turd Ferguson.
Great to be here tonight, Alex.
Okay, and in last place is Lynn Warren, whose score is so low, it can't be represented by a real number.
I've been having a great time tonight, Alex. Tonight I said bells and bings and buzzes, and it's like Atlantic City took a giant crap and out came the 4th of July.
What a lovely image. Let's take a look at the board. And the categories for today are potent potables, letters that begin with G, the number 10, which is a category in which you say the number 10. State your name in that category. All you do is state your name. And famous operas and Let It Snow. Sean, you control the board.
I'll take famous operas for 200.
That's operas, not Oprahs. It's about music, not a person. Lynn Warren. The musical Cats is about this feline animal.
Oprah Winfrey.
No, no, it's not about Oprah. It's not even close to that. Burt Reynolds.
That's not my name. We went over this.
Turd Ferguson.
What are cats, Alex?
You got the question correct.
No, I was actually just posing a question. I was just wondering, what are cats?
Doesn't matter. I'll take it anyways. Just hurry and pick a category.
I'll take, cats. 400, Alex.
That's not a category. Sean, why don't you pick a category, please?
I'll take Oprah for 10,000.
That's not a category. Let's just do the number 10 for 200. And the question is, this is a number between 11 and 9.
I'd like to solve the puzzle, Alex.
This isn't the Wheel of Fortune.
Who is Andre the Giant?
Is that an answer to a question?
No, I was just wondering, who is Andre the Giant?
Whatever. Let's do Let It Snow for 400. And the answer is, this is the color of snow. Sean Connery.
What is yellow?
Incorrect.
Are you sure? I made some yesterday. Spelled your name in a snowbank.
I despise you.
Why don't you give me Andre the Giant for $10,000?
No, that's not a category either. Lynn Warren.
What is the Princess Bride?
You're an idiot.
Sorry, I just love that movie.
Sean, what do you want?
Alex, would it be all right if I answered the next question?
Well, that depends. Are you going to take the game seriously?
Indeed I will. I'd also like to offer my sincere apologies because of the way I'm acting tonight.
Well, thank you, Sean. That means a lot. Why don't you answer the question?
Well, Alex, I believe the answer is your mother, Trebek!
I just remembered something, Alex.
You remembered what?
I remembered who Andre the Giant was. Do you want to know who Andre the Giant was?
Not really.
I remember. See, he was a giant by the name of Andre.
Why are you still talking about Andre the Giant?
I think he was French. Bonjour, madame. I am Andre the Giant.
I hate this show. I despise you all. Let's move on to the final Jeopardy. The final question is, write a number.
Thank you.
All right. Let's start with Lynn Warren. Three. A combination of three and five. Let's see what you wagered. A bass clef and a money sign. Right? Burt Reynolds.
I never got anything else.
Awesome. Cool. John Connery. V. Despite your best efforts, V is actually a Roman numeral, which is five, so you answered correctly. And let's see what you wagered. Suck it, Trebek. Well, that's it for tonight. I'm going home. I hate this show. Goodbye.
But, no, but you can't go home because...
Live from Hastings, it's Monday night!
Welcome to the Variety Show, everyone. Tonight, our skits by the MCs are SNL-themed. I am Andrew Miller, Johan Morales, Matt Liefeld. You just saw Tristan Carlson, Nick McGrath, Alex Ponslet, and Wyatt Cruz.
Today's performances consist of dancing, singing, some piano playing, a very interesting opera, and a number of different stuff. Well, as much as I have to say it, this is going to be a great show. Hopefully it doesn't go wrong. Our first act is Riot Rhythm, and I believe is our only dance group.
Johan, I hate to be the one to tell you, but I'm pretty sure we have another dancer. Elizabeth Piney, ring a bell? Come on, Johan, let's go.
Riot Rhythm, everyone.
Before we let you go, okay? Come up here, girls. We don't bite much.
Hi.
Okay. All right, so how long have you guys been dancing as a group?
15 years.
15 years, wow. And where do you guys get like this dance from? Where are you guys from?
Jane School of Dance.
Jane School of Dance. Well, thank you, girls.
And our next act for y'all tonight, the Mighty Spartan herself, Avery Burt, performing Starlight.
Sandberg, and this is Justin Timberlake.
Here we.
So that was a pretty great performance. How long have you been playing the guitar and singing?
Like 3 years. I'm playing the guitar. I've been singing since I was a little girl.
Here we.
Cool. Now, why did you pick this song?
It just popped up on my Hannah Montana Pandora, which is super weird, but I just thought it'd be easy to play, and I like to sing it, so.
Great.
Hey, wee!
Next, we've got William Melange playing some improvisations on the piano.
8 years. Eight years is a long time. And now, how many instruments do you play total?
Including the percussion instruments, I play 6.
All right, cool. I don't play 6 instruments. However, I am just like you in the sense that when I get up every morning, I put my pants on one leg at a time. Except when I put my pants on, I sell gold records. So, now I was just gonna get you, this was great, but I was just gonna give you a couple points. I brought in Matt here, our professional cowbellist. And I was thinking maybe if you wanted to try improv again, you know, that C minor key, I think, and then with a little bit of cowbell, which is slightly flat of pitch, I feel like it's just musical magic. Okay, now let's give that a shot, I think. Are you game for that? All right, let's try that again. One more time. And now I know the cowbell usually cuts above everything else, so they tell you to pull back, and this is the one time where I'm gonna tell you don't pull back. Leave it all there. Okay, see, it's kind of like, you're my doctor, and I have a fever, and the only prescription is more cowbell. So what I'm asking you to do is save my life with more cowbell, doctor. Can you do that?
Do that.
Thank you, one more time, from the top. Correct. Just dial back, just a smidge. Straight up, Hot 100, Top 40, music magic. Like, you were clunking bars, my friend. And just like that. That was perfect. All right, now, our next act. Sam. Izzy Kranz and Maria Everson singing Somewhere Only We Go, correct? There we go. Hand for them, everybody.
Don't we go?
somewhere only we know.
That's wonderful. I like it. Did y'all like it? Okay, it's just some generic questions. How long have you been into singing?
Since the day we were born. Mm.
So you guys were womb buddies?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. And you have help from your accompanist and your page turner. Let's give it up for Zach for being a page turner. And don't forget Kaylin, because she actually played. So, Zach, is that all you do, turn pages? Because I wanted to know, what's up with that? Hoo-wee-ah! What's up with that? What's up with that? Hoo-wee-ah! What's up with that? What's up with that? Thank you, girls and Kai, for coming here. Best of luck, and that was amazing.
Thank you.
Now, our next performer goes by the name Jake Schultz. And you hear that, Jake? You have recognition. Well, to change from the singing style, he's going to do his guitar solo. The song. It's like a tick, you can't get rid of it. Okay, Jake Schultz's song, Eruption by Van Halen, everyone.
Van Halen.
Rock on, Van Halen.
Now, how long have you been playing?
About 2.5 years.
uber cool. I think you got a girlfriend over there or something, huh? Jeez. Now, do you have a favorite guitar?
I have a few, actually, but I can't name them. Joe Satriani, Steve Vai, Randy Rhodes, Sinister Gates, Dimebag Darrell.
Shout out to all those guys, that's cool. You seem uber talented. Now, I got a talent coach backstage. Welcome, everybody, our special weekend update, weeknight update guest, Stefan, everybody. Coming in hot, Stefan.
Yes, Nick.
How are you tonight, Stefan?
I'm doing good. How are you?
Oh, I'm just Andy, you know. Now, you're our chief weeknight update talent dude, guru. Now, have you seen good talent so far? Are you happy with our show?
Yes. I have seen very good talent tonight.
Good. Do you have any talent to recommend to us? Any acts we should try to get?
I do have some very good talent to recommend for you guys tonight.
Who?
We have Tristan Carlson and Cece Roach dancing to Thinking Out Loud.
Sweep you off of your feet. Will your mouth still remember the taste of my love? Will your eyes still smile from your cheek? Darling, I will be loving you till 70. Baby, my heart could still fall as hard at 23. And I'm thinking about how people fall in love in mysterious ways. And maybe it's all part of a plan. Well, I'll just keep on making the same mistakes, hoping that
to dance for the show, and I found someone to choreograph it, Trina Wald, so we did a dance.
Well, I think you need a non-girly man over here.
Yeah.
Franz? Yeah. Franz, should we give one for this lady?
Yes, I think we shall.
How do you like that one?
See, oh. That's a real man.
Are you dating this girly man?
Yeah.
I'm so sorry.
I feel bad for you. You should get a real man like me and Hans, Franz over here.
Yes, me and Hans, we are real men. Real men.
Well, Franz, it's time to move on to the show. Let's go pop up this girly man over here.
All right, next is going to be Zach Wallace singing Broken. Broken just like this girly man's dreams over here.
Greetings, paying audience and units.
Hello.
Well, hello. Who instructed you in the art of acoustic units?
Mostly myself, but my dad started me off because he was a big musician and he's like a big influence around here, and he did a lot of stuff in Minneapolis and he really got me into the environment, and so it was really cool. And yeah, big shout out to my dad because he taught me all the thing I knew.
What educational status are you in the school of high?
Well, I'm a freshman, but if you're talking about how smart I am, I don't know, 0.7.
No, I can't. Very nice. Very nice.
Thank you, Conehead.
You're welcome, human unit.
I'm not an imposter!
Next is Sarah Erickson.
Soldiers coming.
to be mine? Are you a cop? Look, how green are my papers? Welcome to the neighborhood, mis amigos. My name is Señor Juan, and today we have a special guest named Sarah. She came to sing for all of us. She was very pretty. What do you guys think? Now, Sarah, what grade are you in?
I'm in 10th grade.
Okay. Why did you sing this song?
It's my mom's favorite song, so I'm singing it for her.
She's doing it for her mama. It's very good for you. I like it. Thank you for being in the neighborhood. Best of luck to you. And we'll see you later. Well, children, guess what time it is? It's time for the word of the day. Can you know what the word of the day is? Voltage. Now, do you know what's special about the word voltage? Do you know what voltage is? I know what voltage is. It really hurts when you cross the border. Mi hermano Juan, my brother Juan, he was the one who didn't make it. You know, Jack be nimble, Jack be quick, Jack jump over the border. He wasn't Jack. There's one more thing that's special about the word voltage. Voltage is the name of a band that will be performing here today. But the sad part is, this is their last performance ever. It pains me to say. But let's give a big hug and big day for Voltage. Welcome, Voltage, everyone.
Thank you.
and with me as always is Garth.
Purdy and Wayne.
Purdy and Garth. Excellent. So what you up to, Garth?
Oh, I just watched this sick band, Voltage. They're pretty sweet.
Oh, really?
Yeah, they're right over there.
Whoa, hey, Voltage!
Come over here!
Yeah, come on over here!
We're not worthy! We're not worthy!
Voltage. Yeah, cool.
Yeah.
Voltage. So, we're just gonna interview you guys. It's so cool for our show.
Yeah.
So, how long y'all been a band?
We've been a band, me and Patrick, for about 4 years, and then we got Ben in, and then Jay after, and now Kaylin.
Excellent. Excellent.
Cool.
And what's your favorite band memory?
I have to say this past Saturday, we did Rock the Church over the New Arts Center. We did Sweet Home Alabama at the very end with all three bands together, three drum sets all up on stage, and I don't even know how many guitars. It was a really good time.
No way. No way. No. Oh man, that's awesome. So we made a top 10 list for you guys because we thought you guys would be here. Yeah. That's pretty cool. And just so happens to be top 10 things about rock and roll, so we wanted you guys to hear that. All right. Yeah.
Wayne's World. Top 10 things about rock and roll. Party.
Awesome. All right, number 10 thing about rock and roll is the hair. The hair, that's really cool. Rock and rollers usually have pretty cool hair.
What happened to your hair?
I don't know.
You should borrow some from Dee Schneider because it looks like he's got extra.
All right.
Number nine, what is it, Garth?
Ill-fitting clothing,
Patrick Kelly's jeans.
Wait, if we don't hurry this along, I think I'm gonna hurl.
Garth. Okay, fine. Well, let's just go to number three.
Skip to number three.
Cool. Number three. Female band members. Patrick, she's a babe.
Swing.
Yeah, she's totally babelicious. She's like Mega Babatron 3000.
Swing.
Excellent.
Scene.
Okay.
It's okay.
Now it's back on. It's cool.
All right. So let's just move on to number two.
Number two, Garth.
Band names.
Bands always have cool names.
Yeah, like Led Zeppelin.
Or like Lynyrd Skynyrd.
Or Pink Floyd.
Or AC/DC. That's like electricity and stuff.
It's like you guys.
Yeah, that's like Voltage.
Do you steal your name from them?
Actually, we stole our name from the Mountain Dew.
Excellent. Excellent. Party on. That's awesome. Excellent. All right. Number one thing about rock and roll is
guitar solos.
That's awesome. Excellent.
Just like yours, Patrick. Did you see that guy here tonight who did the V guitar? How'd you like him?
He was pretty awesome.
Hey, I'm gonna have to ask you to stay in the down and locked position.
Yeah, stay in your seat.
Stay. We don't want any liability issues, okay?
Yeah, this is a live show.
This is just public access, okay?
What do you think about him joining the squad?
Might happen. I don't know.
Excellent.
All right.
Party on. All right. Well, we have more talent, right?
Yeah.
Right.
I think it's Catherine McCord. She's singing for us, guys.
Oh, cool. Oh, there she is. Now, Catherine McCord.
Party on, guys.
And scene, everybody. Woo!
Il dolce suono.
Okay. Welcome back to Weeknight Update and right back by popular demand. Hello, dear.
She wanted
Hello.
To.
How are you?
I'm great.
You're great.
Now, that's opera, right?
Yes.
Okay, now where did you get into opera singing?
Actually, through this song, it's from the movie The Fifth Element. It's a sci-fi movie my mom would always watch with us. And I thought it was so beautiful that I wanted to learn it. And then I just really loved this type of singing, so kind of went on from there.
Cool. Well, you're stellar at it. Now, you're very talented, so I want to hook you up with a special appointment, courtesy of Weeknight Live, with our talent coach, Stefan. Is that okay?
Okay, everybody, Stefan, everybody. Hello, Stefan!
Hello, Nick.
Are you still satisfied with our little production?
I'm getting more and more satisfied every time.
Oh, good, 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 good. Okay, so do you have any other talents you would like to recommend to us? Anything else you got up your sleeve?
These girls are very new. They're called the Roomies, and they're singing Oceans.
Very cool. Welcome to the Roomies.
Of my Savior, Spirit, lead me.
me walk upon the waters wherever you would call me. Take me deeper than my feet could ever wander, and my faith will be made stronger in the presence of my Savior. Ooh. Oh.
Good job, girls. Alright, first of all, we have a couple questions for you. So, I got a question. Why are you guys called the Roomies?
Well, we are all in Riverside, and when Riverside goes on long competitions far away, we stay in hotels, and we all room together, and that's kind of special to us. So we thought it'd be fun to be called the Roomies.
Very interesting. Bye-bye.
So, I've heard that you, Mickey, play a lot of instruments. May I hear some of the names of those instruments?
Well, I play violin, trumpet.
That's great. Bye-bye. Bye. Bye. Hey, Becca. So, I have a question. How long have you been singing?
For a really long time, but...
That's great. Can you just go bye? Bye-bye. Yeah, walk.
Hello, Sarah. How long have you been playing the piano?
I've been playing for about 9.
Oh, thanks. Bye-bye. Bye-bye.
Bye.
Yes, sir! Up next, we have a listener and praying for you.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Bye. Yeah, bye.
That was so good.
For a friend, he and I are pretty close. And out of all my friends, well, this one I'm concerned the most. He said he reading daily, but he ain't really learning. He be in church and say that he ain't moved by any sermon. His face weak, he ain't craving a week. He wake up and just weep with his face in the sink. Lord, you gotta help my man. I'm praying for him daily. He ain't sin, but he just seem like he's going crazy. He say he feeling trash, can't even help them all. Cause every lady's half dressed, tempting him to list them all. He keep the TV up, videos just make him feel that he ain't really nothing with that money, girls. Or shiny wheels. The other day they told me he felt less than that, cause he ain't got a 5-year plan over a piece of land. And man, it's crazy cause his family takes so much of it. Plus he got a guy and a girl who always showing love for him. But he's struggling, even though he talks to me, I tell him what he do, but he ain't listen where he ought to be. I'm scared for him, cause the people that look up to him, he got some younger siblings who be changed by what he's done for them. But is it done for him? Lord, don't let it be. Cause if he don't wanna talk to you, Father, hear from me. Is it done for him? Lord, don't let it be. Cause if he don't wanna talk to you, Father, hear from me. God, his condition is worsened since we were last conversing. I'm with him now, he ain't doing well, and this is certain. He say he trying to trust you, doesn't want to discuss you, but he was in the midst of sinners and did not discuss you. And just today, his anxiety has got the best of him. He knows Christ, but for hours refused to rest in him. He's not the best of man, Lord, I know he really loves you, but I can understand why lately he's not thinking of you, because there's a change in him, and it affects us strong. Can you open up his heart for the next song? And when he gets home, I pray he open up the 66 book love letter you wrote and soaking up, because he ain't hearing you, and he ain't feeling me, and God is killing you, because it's killing me. As a matter of fact, there's something else he's concealing. See, the person that I've been praying about is really me.
And swing as successfully in tight slacks. I am Jortag, and this is my brother, Georg, and we are
two wild and crazy guys!
Now, how'd you learn how to cruise and swing so successfully?
At Jan School of Dance.
Oh, good job, Jan. She's really killing it out here. Now, can we teach you a dance move that how we get all the American foxes.
Yeah.
All right, so you take your hands like this. Hey!
I think she got it.
I think she does. Now, one more question. Would you like to go on a ride with us in our stretch limousine?
That we own.
For work.
Oh, okay, I guess.
All right, let's go! Hey!
Next up is Anthony!
And we are two wild and crazy guys!
Lying there in bed and listening to his newborn baby cry. He makes a pot of coffee, splashes water on his face. His wife gives him a kiss and says it's gonna be okay. It won't be like this for long. One day we'll look back laughing at the week we brought her home. This phase is gonna fly by, yeah. If you can just hold on, it won't be like this for long. Four years later, about 4:30, she's crawling in their bed. And when he drops her off at preschool, she's clinging to his leg. The teacher peels her off of him. He says, what can I do? She says, now don't you worry, this'll only last a week or two. It won't be like this for long. One day soon you'll drop her off and she won't even know you're gone. This phase is gonna fly by. He's trying to hold on. It won't be like this for long. Someday soon she'll be a teenager, and at times he'll think she hates him, and he'll walk her down the aisle and wave her veil. But right now she's up there crying, and the truth is that he don't mind. as he kisses her goodnight and she says her prayers. He lays down there beside her till her eyes are finally closed. Just watching her, it breaks his heart, 'cause he already knows it won't be like this for long. One day soon that little girl's gonna be all grown up and gone, and this phase is gonna fly by. He's trying to hold on, 'cause it won't be like this for long. It won't be like this for long.
Cheeseburger. I've been singing since pretty much I could talk.
Chips, and Pepsi. Chips and a Pepsi.
I chose this song mainly because I'm a senior, and this song's like about growing up and entering the real world, facing real challenges.
Cheeseburger. Up next is Elizabeth Brooke Anderson singing Something in the Water.
Church Chat, everybody. Welcome to Church Chat, dear. What's your name?
I'm Elizabeth.
Welcome, Elizabeth. I'm the church lady. This Church Chat. See how we're chatting? This Church Chat. Shh! We're talking about Jesus. Now, a question I like to ask all our guests, are you baptized in Jesus' name?
Yes, I am.
Isn't that special? Now, I just love that. So where'd you hear that?
I heard it on Spotify.
Spotify. They got lots of religious hymns. Yours is my favorite. Something in the holy water. I just love that too. No, it's
not. No.
What is it?
It's something in the water.
Not the holy water?
No.
That's interesting. You know, that reminds me, I brought this letter I was going to share with y'all from Church Chat, from a loyal Church Chat viewer, and Granny needs her bifocals here. Excuse me. Now, this was from Christmas time, but I haven't done a show recently, about 25 years, so I'm just going to read this here. It's a dear church lady, I am shocked at the number of people who bring their children into total strangers in Santa suits, you know, like mall Santas, it's despicable, and allow them to hold their young ones firmly on their pelvic regions, offer them candy, and whisper, don't be afraid to tell me what you really want. What causes this mass hysteria? Signed, Elaine. Well, Elaine, I've been thinking since Christmas, so I've had about a month to think about it. And I'm kind of a linguist, so I was examining, and I think this plays into your situation about how, you know, the water's not holy anymore, especially in Flint. I was thinking, now, if we look at Santa, and we examine the word itself, we got an S, an A, an N, a T, and another A. Now, being the linguist that I am, using my mind tricks, taking my omega-3s. Now, you know what this is. So she got me. She must be on omega-3, too. Now, look, we rearrange letters and we get S-A-T-A-N. Satan? Is that what this all really is? This is Satan. Satan, he's taken the holy out of the water. He's taken the fame of Christmas away from the baby born, sweet baby Jesus. It's Satan. It's despicable. But how convenient that Santa and Satan have the same letters. Think about that when y'all go home. Now, dear, we have a special, special guest. The Lakeside Corporation, you may remember them. So we have some fellers backstage, all gonna, you know, swing and dance for y'all. So we have the Lakeside Corporation. Everybody, thank you for joining us on Church Chat.
Thank you.
That was pretty good. That was pretty good. I might have to take some lessons. Hey, fellas. So, where'd you guys come up with that idea?
I don't know. I was looking online and I saw it and I wanted to do something like really different that like has never been done here before. So last year we did lip singing and then we figured synchronized swimming probably hasn't been done ever.
Well, you were definitely right about that. My only question is, wouldn't it be more beneficial if you guys spent your time, you know, studying, especially with finals last week? It would have been a lot better for you if you would have been studying, not spending so much time on your synchronized swimming. So just to give you guys a quick lesson, I hired a motivational speaker. So now if you guys please just listen. This guy sent me back a few bucks. His name's Matt Foley. He's been sitting behind the curtain for about an hour now drinking coffee, one after another. Stay right here. Stay right here. I'll go get him. Hey, Matt. Matt, we're ready for you.
Hey, how's it going, everybody? How's it going on? As your father probably told you, my name is Matt Foley, and I am a motivational speaker. Now, I'm going to tell you a little bit about myself. I am 35 years old, I am divorced, and I live in a van down by the river. Now, you guys are probably thinking, hey, Matt, I'm going to go out there and get the world by the tail and wrap it up and put it in my pocket. Well, I'm here to tell you that you're probably going to figure out as you go out there, that you're not going to amount to jack squat. You're gonna be living off a steady diet of government cheese and living in a van down by the river. Now, young man, what do you want to do with your life?
Actually, Matt, I kind of want to be a writer.
Well, Lottie freaking duh! Hey, Dad, I can't see you real well. Is that Bill Shakespeare over there?
I don't know, we've actually kind of been encouraging him in his writing abilities.
Dad, I wish you'd just shut your big yapper! Now, young man, what do you want to do with your life?
I want to live in a van down by the river.
Well, you'll have plenty of time for living in the van down by the river when you're living in a van down by the river. Now, I think you guys are probably asking yourselves, hey, Matt, how am I supposed to get myself back on the right track? And as I see it, there is only one solution. I'm going to go get my gear and I'm going to room with you guys. We're going to be buddies. We're going to be pals. Old Matt here is going to be your shadow. Here's you. Here's Matt. There's you. There's... we're going to have to clean that up later. Me and my buddies, my pals, my amigos. I'm going to go get my gear.
I don't think you need to do that. I think it's okay. I think they understand.
I don't give a rat's behind what you think. I'm moving in. I'm sick and tired of living in a van down by the river.
Okay. Let's finish this up here before he gets back. All the acts, you can come on stage.
Hey, go up there.
You guys, come on up. Yes, you guys. Now, As you can plainly see, I am not Steve Harvey and neither is him. So it's okay. We're not gonna screw up. So.
All right. In third place, is this on? Can you guys hear me? No?
And we need your help. Hey, there we go. So in third place is, drumroll please. Actually, we'd like to give some thanks to some people. I'm gonna give it over to the church lady over here.
Well, I would first like to thank Jesus.
Shout out to God and Jesus. Lots of people to thank tonight. Our crew backstage, moving ons and offs and queuing church ladies and not church ladies. Thank you to those people. Shout out to Mr. Lindley Charles Warren in the back. We're not worthy of your service, but thank you for coordinating and auditioning and everything. Thank you to our judges tonight for all of that you do. Thank you to everybody up in the sound box, Anne and company, for keeping mics so people can hear church ladies and not church ladies alike. Thank you to everybody here for auditioning, trying out, coming here, practices, etc., etc. Thank you to my grandma for the corduroy skirt.
All right, I think we're done here.
We also like to thank all of you guys for coming out and making this so awesome. So give it up for yourself. All right, so now the moment we've all been waiting for. In third place, Jake Schultz. Come on up. We'd like to remind all of our participants that there is money in here. So don't lose it.
Cash money.
Not for the church. All right, second place, drum roll please. We have Will Longy. First place, they got it, Catherine McCord.
Congratulations for all the performance tonight. Thank you so much for all your hard work and dedication to this. Thank you guys all for coming. Have a safe drive home. Enjoy your night. Thank you.